Hello friends, welcome back to GK Code Labs. Today I'm going to discuss about a basic use case or requirement that is put up as a question in many interviews. This is basically asked you to test your basic understanding on Spark APIs and how comfortable you are in using them programmatically. Let me demonstrate this simple use case. You will be given two files. One will be the input file that will contain the input data from the business upstream, and the second file which may contain some values that are valid as per business requirement. So now you have to read the input data and also look up on the valid data that business has given. And whatever data is valid in this input file, that you need to segregate to one valid file, whatever name you want, and the invalid data should go to another file. Let's call it rejects. So in this tutorial, I'll build this code using Spark data frame APIs. And as usual, I'll build all these things from scratch. So if you want, you can build it along with me. Also, I'll try to break this down into very simple steps that will help you to easily understand the logic. So I'll go to my VM. I'll open my IntelliJ. Okay, so my IntelliJ is ready. I'll create a Scala object. Let's name it Spark data frame tutorial. Okay, so this is our object. Let's define a main class. So guys, as we are going to use Spark data frames, we should be using the Spark SQL context. But in the latest version, Spark has provided us a Spark session that includes it all. So I'm going to use Spark session in this tutorial. If you want more details on SQL context, Spark session, Spark context, let me know. I'll make another video on that. So I'll define a Spark session. Let's name it Spark. Spark session. So it will prompt you to import the Spark session library. So this is basically, make sure you have the Spark latest Spark SQL dependency in your project. So with Spark session.builder, we can define few basic configurations like app name. Let's name it anything. Spark. Yeah. And let's define the master. So I'm going to run it on my local only. And final method is get or create. So our Spark session is ready. So I've created one data set. I'll show you, there is a small data set that I've created with user details. So this is basically my data set. I have transaction IDs, username, user type, and transaction date. And with these columns, I have basically 10 records. Now, for the lookup, as we saw in our demo, I have created one small lookup file. Suppose business tells us that for us, valid year is 2019. So let's take a small lookup file only for now. Here you can see if user detail table, I can see transaction dates are in totally date format, but few dates are for 2019 and few dates are for 2018. So as I explained here, lookup file has 2019. Input file has many columns, but date column, many dates are there and also in date format. And out of which, from lookup, I am getting only the year. This in itself will be another interview question. Make sure you watch it closely. Now, as I told, what you have to do, you have to segregate 2019 transactions and 2018 transactions. 2018s will be going to rejects. So coming back to my VM. Now the second step is read the input file into a data frame. So let's say our data frame 1. And we'll use spark.read command from our Spark session. Format will be CSV. First option that we can give is we have the header. We will define a condition with header as true. Then next option we can give infer schema. True. Then finally we can use load option, and here we can give the path for that data set. CSV. So this will load our user details data into df1 data frame. If you want, you can execute an action df1.show and let's see if the data is loaded into data frame. So we got our output, and you can see our file is loaded into a data frame. Transaction ID, username, user type, transaction date. And let me take care of this. You can see there are so many logs. So Spark introduces lot of logs while executing any Spark program. You can see here log4j properties, all these properties are set. So by default, it introduces lot of log messages. So if you want, if you are interested, I'll tell you, like, we can use a logger property. This you have to import a logger jar. We have to import the log4j.logger. There is a method we can set its level to level.off, and for level also you can import the log4j level, but make sure you define it before creating a Spark session, otherwise there is no use. So here you can see we have a clean output, no unnecessary logs. So this is our first data frame. So let's move on. I don't want to show it now. Now if you notice, we have a transaction date, but in our lookup file we have just the year. So this was the same thing I was telling. This is in itself, it is another question for an interview. How can we introduce another column with just the year, taking from the same transaction dates? Let's try to do this. I'm breaking it down into several steps just to make you understand. That is why I'm doing every operation in a new data frame. I'll create a new data frame. Suppose we call it add column. So here what we can do, we can take our data frame one, first thing. Here we'll use with column property of data frames. So with column will add one more column with whatever condition we provide, considering other pre-existing columns for that data frame, here df1. So what is the syntax? In with column, you have to first give the name, what new column name will be which you are going to introduce. Let's say we are going to add a column year. Now what will be the values of this column? That we can give separated by a comma, and we have to access the column which we are going to put some conditions on. Like here we have to consider transaction date, and from here we have to take only the year part. So there is very basic function substr, if you know, substring. What we can do, take the values of transaction date. We'll take it like dollar transaction underscore date. So if you see this kind of error, dollar is not a member of string context. There are few internal Spark functions that will only be available if you introduce Spark implicits for a Spark session. So as soon as you create Spark session, just introduce a statement with import Spark implicits everything from this. So Spark will understand, okay, this is a column. So here what we have to do, take the value of transaction date and do a substring. We have to take, if you can see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7th character, and from 7th character we have to take 4 more characters. So syntax is like start character and the length, if you can see it's prompting the length till which you have to take the substring. So 7 to 4 should be fine for us. Also, let's keep checking step by steps. What are the values that we are getting? Let's see, show. And let's execute it. I'll clear this. Good, as we expected, a new column year is introduced and it's getting the substring from the respective transaction dates. So good, we have add column data frame. Now let's read the lookup file also, so that it will be easy for us to use it as a data frame. So we'll read the lookup file. Again, the same code we can use. It will be df2 and everything will be same, just the file name we can change, valid year.csv. So our df2 will be having the lookup value. So I'll remove this show action. Also, just keep in mind, if you are going to use this in Spark SQL, any of the data frame, you have to create a temporary view for that particular data frame. Then only it will be accessible as a table. So there is a simple method inside the data frame dot create or replace temp view. Whatever view you want, I'll give the same name. So now you can access this data frame in Spark SQL. Let's do the same thing for df2. So now we are good to use these data frames, df2, add call, in our Spark SQL statements. So we'll define our Spark SQL statement with the same Spark session object, spark dot SQL context dot SQL. So this will provide you a good function. Dot SQL will take entire SQL query as a string. So let's do one thing, create a join on this table with our lookup table. So we'll take select star from, add call, join. Let's do a left join so that we get the null values also. I believe you are aware of the left join. Left join, whatever columns are not matching, that will come from the left table. Left table is add call. I will give it an alias A. So left join with df2 that has our valid year. Left join with df2 alias B on a dot year, sorry, a dot year equal to B dot, we'll see what was the column name, it's valid year, B dot valid year. So let's see what this data frame gives us, dot show. So this is giving us the join with the valid year, and you can see whatever is matching 2019 will obviously only match, and others are coming as null. So what will be our valid records? Only 2019 ones. So we have all the join data here. What we can do, we can just take, we can make it a subquery, and we can select transaction ID, username, user type, and transaction date. This we have to select. From this table, and just for filtering these null and 2019 condition, suppose we want only the null values, that is the reject records for our requirement, we'll mention where valid year is null. Let's see this. So here you go, if we are mentioning is null, we are perfectly getting only the 2018 data. Again, for valid data, we'll put the same condition. Just we'll mention is not null, because in the joins, whatever are matching, that year value won't be null. Let's see the output. So perfectly we are getting 2018 data and 19 data separately from one single file based upon the lookup. So if you want to write them to different files, as the interviewer gave us the requirement, what we can do, I will remove the show method. We don't want to see the output, but we can mention dot write. And whatever option you want to give, you want the headers also, then option header should be true. We want it in a CSV format again, and any path you can give. I'll give this output folder path slash output slash, this will be our is null, that means it will be reject. Reject's output will be in this, and again the same thing we can mention for the valid ones. We'll create a valid here, valids. So that's all basically. We have removed the show, so now we won't be getting this directly. Our output will be going to the respective directories. Let's execute finally and see what we are getting. Here the execution is complete. Let's go to our output directory. We can see we have got two folders, rejects. This is the part file for reject. We'll see all are the 2018 transactions, and let's see the valids, all the 19 transactions. So in this video we saw how you can use Spark Data Frame API to read an input file, and based upon the lookup file values you can divide those transactions into valid and rejects. If you have any other doubts or any other use case scenarios that you have been asked, or it is coming up in your mind, just let me know in the comment section. And if you like this video, please hit that like button and please subscribe to our channel. See you guys, bye.